After I spread the thin set with 30 degrees, I'm using a half an inch here, travel. I want to show you from close how does it look. So this is the way that it's look from here. And the reason I'm using half an inch is this is a big time, which is a 1 by 2 feet. So you have to use at least half an inch, and it's a porcelain tile. So I want to show you the next what I have to do. Take butter tile. Big bottle, that's the way it looks like, big bottle time. And what left now is just to put it. And slowly move it to the left and the right. This time is done, I'm going to put it second time. Second time, also you have to put back bottle. The way it looks like. Move it left, right. Make sure. Second time is almost done. I'm using level here. Just to make sure the tiles are level. Press it lightly. What I'm doing here, I'm actually putting in the center of the tile, and then I just hit it a little bit to make sure that it's good. That's good. So because this tile is in the corner, I'm going to use it's called a scribe notch, 90 degrees, just to make sure that I think it's inside. It looks very good, it's inside. Thing is very good inside. Second thing I'm going to do, I'm going to take a stick, and this stick is very level. So if you look here, you'll see how the stick is level. With a level, taking this stick, let's make sure that everything here starts to be level. It's not very good. This is the first two tiles, and I'm going to put the next two tiles on top of it. So I'm using this spacer just to put here. See, I need to put more spacers. That's okay. So I'm going to put a second roller. It's going to clean with a sponge here. To remove a little minor of the thin set, and this is done. So here again, I'm going to spread thin set here on this area, 30 degrees, as needed. So remember, the most important to spread it first, 30 degrees on the wall. There is more. As you can see, the things are spread evenly on the wall. Sometimes it's easy to spread the thin set on the tile when you're actually working in walls, but if you would do it, so what you have to do, you have to bake butter. So what I'm doing here, I will spread the thin set with a half an inch trowel on the tile, but I will make the baked butter here on the roll using a quarter of an inch trowel. Now take this. It's kind of easy, it's another way to do it. You see how easy it is. Put a quarter of an inch trowel just to make baked butter on the wall, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to put the thin set on the tile, half an inch, then I put in the wall. Let me show from close how does it look. So that's the way it took, the quarter of an inch a trowel on the wall. That's the baked butter really, so you can see all the lines are parallel. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to put a half an inch trowel on the tiling itself. Remember, I must use half an inch at least a trowel to put tiles that are bigger than 1 foot by 1 foot. So you must spread the skin to 30 degrees all over the tile. First thing, you have to spread it. So remember, I put quite a bit of thin set here on this tile that will accommodate the half an inch trowel. So you clean the trowel before, and then so as you can see clearly, this is a half an inch trowel, so you can see that the lines should be parallel to each other. I'm going to put it on the wall and see what's happened. Just clean before you put it on the wall. What I'm doing here, I'm just cleaning it with a sponge. Okay. Using this dry notch, you want to make sure it's 90 degrees perpendicular to each other here. And here, place this. So that's it. That's the first tile. This is the last tile that's going to be here. So I actually already spread a thin set on the tile. You can see here, that's the way it looks. Okay, what left now, just to clean it. Okay. Just clean it. And I'm going to put it now. Just have to move it left and right to make sure the thin set is spread properly. Okay, now taking the level, I'm taking the stick which is level also. Let's make sure that the thin set is spread very evenly on the tile. So the only thing left here is put the spacer. That's the way it's good. That's the last tile on the second row. Nothing left now for the end, just to clean here the tinset, but what I'm doing here, I'm just taking the tinset and I just put it inside. You see, there is a kind of a void spaces here, a little bit. So I'm just put it here. And clean it. So this is a very good use of the tinset. And it also put more tinset under the tile, which is very good. I'll show you how it looks like. Always clean after you finish with a sponge, with a wet sponge. So I want to show you how it looks like after you clean it and you push the tinset under the tile. You see, that's the way it looks like. So, and also you have to clean the space between the space. Look how the spaces is clean. You should not have any tinset between spaces, otherwise you're going to have a lot of work to clean it up. So here what I did, I actually put a level. I just put now the two tiles here just to make sure, to verify that everything is actually leveled perfectly. And if you work properly, it has to be level. So you can look here and you see it's exactly on the center, which means it is 100% level. So this is the way it looks like, really. And that was very easy to finish it in a day. So here's another verification that I'm doing. So you can see how level it is. And that's the way it should look like. If you really want to have a job, a wall that looks nice and almost perfect, you have to verify all the time that the tiles are level with each other with no problems. And some people, what they're doing, they're actually moving something like that to see if there is no bump, okay, between the tile. But if it's level, there is no bump anyway. You can see there's nothing here or here.